Antibiotic Prophylaxis for Hysterectomy, a prospective cohort study, cefuroxime, metronidazole, or both. This is an outline of our presentation. We'll start off the background, aim, methods, and results. Then we'll go on to criticisms, literature review, and summary of findings. This paper is a national collaborative prospective observational study done in Finland, also known as FinHist 2006. It is done across 53 hospitals. There are 5,279 hysterectomies performed for benign indications. Data on indications, antibiotics, and thrombosis prophylaxis, etc. were collected. According to NICE guidelines, before any clean contaminated surgeries, antibiotic prophylaxis should be given. However, no specific antibiotic was recommended. According to ACOG recommendation, for any gynecological procedures, cefazolin 1 or 2 grams should be used. The aim of this paper is to evaluate cefuroxime and metronidazole in the prevention of post-operative infections. Methods. A prospective observational study was done across 53 hospitals. For every patient, a study form was completed at discharge by the surgeon. At follow-ups, at the outpatient clinics, a separate form was completed for each patient in the case of infections. Patients were not randomized or allocated to any form of antibiotics. The antibiotics used were chosen based on local hospital policies or according to the surgeon's preference. Logistic regression was used for analysis. In this paper, post-operative wound infection, urinary tract infection, febrile event, pelvic infection, total infection are defined as on this slide. Results. Out of the 5,279 hysterectomies, data was only available for 5,240, of which 2.5% were not given any antibiotic prophylaxis. Cefuroxime alone was given to 38.5%, and metronidazole alone was given for 9.9%. Both cefuroxime and metronidazole were given to 43% of the patients. The rest of the patients were given other antibiotic prophylaxis. For dosage-wise, cefuroxime dose was only reported 38% of the time, of which majority used IV 1.5 grams. Metronidazole dose was reported 24% of the time, of which majority used IV 0.5 gram. In view of the lack of data on dosage, the use of antibiotics were analyzed irrespective of dosage. Of all the hysterectomies done, majority, 44%, were vaginal hysterectomies. The rest were abdominal and laparoscopic hysterectomies at 24% and 32% respectively. This table shows the results broken down into type of hysterectomies and prophylaxis given versus the total infection rate. Of note, if metronidazole is used alone for prophylaxis, occurrence of total infections is increased for all types of hysterectomies. This table compares the risk of infections if cefuroxime was used versus if cefuroxime was not used, including cases where other types of antibiotics were given. Similarly, for metronidazole, it compared risk for infections if metronidazole was used versus if metronidazole was not used. The results showed a significant risk reductive effect if cefuroxime was used. For metronidazole, there was no significant risk reductive effect. This table compares the risk of infections if ceftriaxone was used versus a combination of ceftriaxone with metronidazole. Similarly, it also compares the risk of infections if metronidazole was used versus a combination of ceftriaxone with metronidazole. For metronidazole, there was a significant increase in risk of total infections, especially febrile events. For ceftriaxone, there was no significant difference. This graph shows that the longer the operation, the higher the risk of infection. With metronidazole alone, there was a high increase in infection rate. But between ceftriaxone and a combination of ceftriaxone and metronidazole, there was no significant difference. In conclusion, the findings of the paper was that ceftriaxone was effective as prophylaxis against infection. Ceftriaxone combined with metronidazole offered no additional benefit. Metronidazole alone appeared to be ineffective. The results of this paper could be attributed to the fact that metronidazole has a limited spectrum as it deals mainly with anaerobes. For ceftriaxone, which is a second generation cephalosporin, it has activity against a wide range of aerobic and anaerobic gram-positive and gram-negative organisms. Now, we move on to our critique of the paper. Firstly, no method was used to randomize or allocate patients, which resulted in a vast difference in sampling rate. As shown in this table, metronidazole alone was used in only less than 10% of the operation. Another confounding factor was the fact that dosage and route of administration of the antibiotics were not reported for more than 60% of the patients. For metronidazole, while it was mostly administered through IV, other routes, for example, IM, oral, and per vagina, were also used for some cases. We are unable to tell if there were any underlying factors that led to the choice of the antibiotics. For example, surgeons might have chosen a combination of metronidazole and ceftriaxone for more complicated surgeries. In addition, the duration of follow-up for infections was not specified. In some cases of mild infections, instead of visiting the hospital's outpatient clinics, patients could have visited a GP instead. This infection would have been missed and not recorded in the results. In our literature review, it was found that there are other papers that supported the results of this paper. The conclusion of these papers are shown on this slide. However, locally, we use cefazolin instead of ceftriaxone as prophylaxis, and there have so far been no papers comparing these two antibiotics. In summary, the findings clearly show that ceftriaxone is better than metronidazole for prophylaxis. This could be due to the wider spectrum of ceftriaxone. However, lack of information on dosage of the drug is a severe confounding factor. In terms of our local context, we will also need to compare cefazolin and ceftriaxone and cefazolin in combination of metronidazole in hysterectomies. Thank you for listening to this presentation.